Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today back from my vacation. I was gone for about a week there, and I had a couple videos to tide you over, but now we're gonna get back to the new releases and back to the regular flow of content, kicking things off here with Max Payne 3 on the Xbox 360 playing the multiplayer. Now, this game did release on consoles on May 15th in North America, and it's still not available on the PCs, but it will be on May 29th in North America. So if you're looking for it on that particular platform, you still gotta wait about a week and a half at the time of this recording. Now, I am gonna be showing you some clips of multiplayer. This is not gonna be any one single game or match in particular, and that's because I'm still learning the ropes of Max Payne 3. And I kind of brought that on myself, to be honest. Whenever you're first wanting to join a match, to join the matchmaking, it asks you if you want one of two different types of aim modes. There's like free aim, which is zero auto aim. And then there's like a soft aim lock, so a soft assist kind of game mode, which I didn't actually try out for myself, so I can't really talk about that. So that's why I kind of stink. I'm playing on the free aim game type. I figured I may as well do this right and try to get good at the controls, so that's what I started doing, and it's taken a lot of adjusting, but it is really rewarding all the same, because anytime you get a kill, you're like, yes, I got that kill. The computer did not help me one bit, it was all me. So the way that the multiplayer works in Max Payne 3, I'm not even going to talk about the single player because I have not even tried it. There's a number of different game modes for you to try out. You're going to start with the basics, which is deathmatch and team deathmatch. And as you get experience points from playing and level up, you're going to unlock a lot of different things. But obviously, you're going to unlock more game types, and I'll talk about the game types briefly. The significant ones to me are the painkiller game type, which basically involves you and the rest of your team fighting against two overpowered players. So they're basically going to be like moving King of the Hill zones, and everyone's going to be converging on their positions trying to kill them. And if you kill them, you get to take their place as the superpowered, super buff Max Payne. And then there's another character named Passos who you get to be as well. And they're obviously really strong, got great weapons, things like that. And you're just going to keep exchanging places. When someone kills you, they'll take your place, so on and so forth. So that one's pretty creative. And the other game type that I thought was really cool is the Gang Wars game type, which basically drags you along a five-part series of missions. So the first mission may be like a standoff, like everyone is facing the other team. Think Red Dead Redemption, and then the game starts and you have to kill everyone that's lined up on the other team before they can kill you. And then whoever wins that will basically impact what the next set of missions and maps are to some extent. Now, for example, the next mission might be some kind of search and destroy-esque game type where you're having to plant a bomb on a particular structure and the other team's trying to defuse it, so on and so forth. You get the idea. It's basically five completely different game types all in one game type, and it's really cool. I had a lot of fun playing that, even if my team did get completely clean sweeped. Now, enough about the game modes. There's just a bunch of game modes there, and you're going to be unlocking them as you go. But you're also going to have a lot of other things to unlock. For example, character avatars. You can be different characters. You're going to be unlocking different weapons, and you're going to be buying the weapons with the money that you earn while playing. And you're going to be buying all sorts of different things. There's just tons of unlockables. This game really has it covered. I was very surprised by the amount of depth in the multiplayer. You could play this for quite a while and still not have unlocked anything. Playing it for about 2 or 3 hours, I was still learning everything that this game had to offer. You could customize not just, you know, which particular avatar you're using, but also what hat they're wearing, what shoes they're wearing, what pants they're wearing, so on and so forth. And the guns all have attachments, so if you want to unlock a silencer or be able to dual wield those MAC-10s, you can do that. You just have to be able to be willing to put in the time to unlock them. So overall, very, very impressed with the depth here. That's about as much as I could possibly hope for Max Payne 3 multiplayer. I didn't really know anything about this multiplayer mode coming into it, and I was very pleasantly surprised at the sheer amount that is here for you to just mess around with. How many hours is it going to take to unlock all this? I have no idea. And there's a lot of things I'm probably not going to mention, because like I said, I am still learning a bunch. For example, in some of the missions, it seemed like you could wager money. Like the in-game money, not real-life money, obviously. So if you do certain objectives before somebody else, you know, you'll earn extra cash. So on and so forth. You can challenge people, like give a vendetta whenever they kill you, and it'll mark them on your map. I don't even know. Things happen, people die, and you get shot. Now, as far as the actual gameplay itself goes, I know that's what you're craving the most. Obviously, this is a Max Payne game, and as such, bullet time is a huge part of that. So anytime you see people going slow-mo, Someone's activated bullet time, which is a burst. A burst is a power-up, and you can use different various kinds of bursts, which you can, of course, unlock. So if you don't want bullet time, maybe bullet time in your thing, you can unlock, you know, a health bonus. So whenever you see that meter at the bottom right next to my player outline, which will be increasing as I get kills, get assists, things like that, maybe you don't want bullet time, so you want to switch your loadout to give you and the rest of your team in the general area a health bonus. So you can switch out bullet time for that and then activate that burst, give them a health bonus. What else can you do? You could increase the damage of your guns. You could reveal enemies on the radar. You could even pull out stronger weapons with a burst. But of course, these have to be unlocked for you to be able to use them. Now, I prefer bullet time, so that's what I'm going to be using, because bullet time is sexy. Who doesn't want to shoot dodge around in slow motion, shooting people in the face in the ballet of death? I certainly do. So that is definitely a strong suit to this particular game. The gameplay, the gunplay, feels really solid. It only takes a few bullets to kill someone, which is both good and bad. It means you have to be on top of your game. You have to be able to aim very well, because if you don't, they'll take you down pretty much in an instant. It's really slick though. The guns feel powerful, which I definitely appreciate. I don't like having to, you know, I don't like it when everyone's a bullet sponge, just absorbing damage. Like they're eating the bullets for breakfast. I don't like that. But as I said, the gunplay feels really solid. Everything is very, very polished. The animation system is definitely noteworthy. I don't know if you've seen any of the other video previews of Max Payne, how you can kind of roll around on the ground. So let's say you shoot dodge and you land on your stomach on the ground. Well, rather than waste time getting up, sometimes it's advantageous to just lay there, which you can do by not moving the left stick once you've landed. Then you can roll around with the right stick and aim while laying on the ground. It's really cool, and the animation system, like I said, is very, very finely tuned. So if you try to shoot dodge your way into a wall, you'll just smack your face on the wall and bounce off of it. There's a lot of small details that really kind of make this game what it is. For example, if you're holding a two-handed weapon, like an AK-47, and you want to switch to dual-wielding pistols, well, your character can't hold all those guns. So what it'll do when you switch out to the two pistols is literally drop the AK-47 so that he can dual-wield. I think that's really cool. Some of you guys might be annoyed by the fact that you actually drop your weapon, but don't worry, you'll get it back when you respawn. And trust me, you'll respawn very frequently, especially when you're just starting out. I think my average lifespan was like 30 seconds or something like that, so that's why there's so many cuts in this video. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. This game is really, really fun. I would definitely recommend checking it out. Not sure if it's worth 60 bucks or not, but we'll see. If I make another video of it, I will let you know. Anyways, guys, I want to thank you very much for watching. I appreciate all of your support and be looking for more of my videos coming really soon now that I am back home, ready to start making some more video content. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.